everybody. Ricky here with Apple Valley Farm. Got a good project for you today. Today we're building a tic-tac-toe toilet paper holder. Try to say that 5 times real fast, right? Pretty easy project, but it does require a little bit of forethought before you get into it. I'm gonna show you how to do it. It's really not that hard. Basic materials, basic tools, just like always. So stick with me for a few minutes. I'm gonna show you how to go through this. And in no time at all, you'll be making this and be hanging it up on the wall. Here we go.
All right, so our design is gonna be really simple. 25 inches by 25 inches. It's gonna consist of 8 boards all together, 4 up and down, 4 across, and these are gonna be joined at each of these intersections with half lap joints. Actually, it's technically an edge half lap joint, but I'll show you a little more about that when we get to it. It's an easy joint. You'll be able to do it even if you're not familiar with it. Gonna join this stuff together. I'm gonna tack and glue it also, but you don't have to do that. But anyway, that is the basic thing. And all right, let's get going. Okay, the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna cut 8 1x4s, 25 inches long. Or our toilet paper holder sections are going to be 6 inches by 6 inches, and we're going to make some X's to go in there. Now these X's are also going to be joined with half lap edge joints. Now to go in a 6 inch by 6 inch square, each one of these boards is going to have to be right at about 7.5 inches a piece. So I'm going to cut 6 of those so I can make 3 X's. So everything's cut out. Now, since we don't employ the graces of a table saw here at Apple Valley Farm, we just use a skill saw. So I'm gonna take all 8 of these, I'm gonna put them together, get my edges up nice and tight, get everything up together, and then I'm gonna mark off where we're gonna cut our notches. Then we're gonna use our skill saw, and we're just gonna cut right down through there, making a few passes until we get it 3/4 of an inch wide. We might use a chisel to help notch a few things out a little bit, and then they should just fit right together. So here we go. Okay, the next thing we need to know is we need to make sure the cutting depth of our saw is exactly 1/2 of the width of this. So this is a 1x4. I know a 1x4 is 3.5 inches wide. Okay, that's great. So 1/2 of 3.5. Well, 1/2 of 3 is 1.5, and 1/2 of another 1/2 is 1/4. So that's 1 3/4. So the depth of this needs to be 1 3/4 of an inch. If I do that, it'll be exactly 1/2. Then when I do the other one, it'll be exactly 1/2, and then they'll match right up, and then we'll have flush fitting joints on the edge. So, yes, I've already gotten my saw set, so hopefully I am at 1 3/4, and it looks like I am right at it, if not just a little shy, which is fine. We can always cut more, but we can't put it back. 1 3/4. Okay, so this is the point where we really need to slow down for a minute. I need to slow down for a minute because I want to get the saw and I want to start cutting stuff. But we really need to think about where we're gonna put our notches. We need everything to be even and symmetrical, or at least as symmetrical as possible. So once we get everything together, get it clamped up, get the edges here nice and flush, then you can already see I've made some mistakes as I went down through here. I've got to figure, look over here. I've got to figure 25 inches here, minus 666, minus 18, minus 3/4, 3/4, 3/4, 3/4. So minus 3 more inches, that's a total of 21 inches. 21 inches from 25 inches leaves 4 inches. So instead of 1.5 inches on this on the edge, we need to do 2 inches on the edge. So I measured in 2 inches, then 3/4 of an inch. This is where we're gonna make our cut. 6 more inches, 3/4 inch we'll make our cut, and so on and so on. It's really simple, but again, like you can see right up here, all it takes is a little slip and you're misfiguring the whole thing and you've wasted all this wood. So we really need to slow down, make sure we're measuring everything exactly as it needs to be, marking it off, double checking everything before we cut. That's all cut up. Now let's see how they fit together, just roughly. That's going to be great. Great. So we'll get all these sanded, then we'll start putting them together. Oh yeah. Look at that, man. Woo! That's gonna look good. Everything is sanded. Now we are ready to start staining and painting. So we're going to stain the tic-tac-toe board area, and then we're going to paint the X's. We're going to paint those red. So let's get started. This is all put together pretty well, and chances are it would be just fine like it is. I would rather tack this in the joints just lightly, just to make sure that this stays together well, because if somebody takes it off the wall and they move it around, I don't want it like pieces falling off of it, things like that, because right now it's just held together by these joints, which are fairly tight, but you know, it's just the joint. So anyway, I'm going to tack these in with my Ryobi Airstrike. I'm going to use some 1-inch brads, and I'm just going to tack this very lightly in each one of the joints in at an angle. I'm going to do this on probably what will be the back side, because we don't want these to show. We can always sink them if we need to, but we just don't want them to show. Okay, so running this nail gun in at an angle, it just really doesn't give us the best result. And you can see there, that brad, can you see it? It's sticking up a little bit, so we need to sink that. And that's happening at almost, no, it did not so bad here. It didn't happen at all there. Anyway, it's happening in almost every joint. So we're gonna fix that. We're gonna use a nail set. And these come in different sizes. This is a very small one. I don't know exactly what the size is, but it's the smallest one that I could get. And we're going to take this, and we're going to put this. There's a little dimple right here in the end of it. We're going to take this, set this on the nail head, and I'm going to give it a firm, quick strike, and bam, it'll just drive that right on in there. There we go. So that's all put together. Now, toilet paper rolls can go in here, and our X's will go in here, which we're about to finish up also.